What's up, Studio U family, and welcome to another U Prep Day. This is our second U Prep Day of the year. Go and clap it on up. I'm excited. I hope you're excited. And I promise to make sure we don't hold you long enough. I know we've all been in this virtual world for a long period of time, so staring at a computer screen can get frustrating. But we are here to enjoy, we are here to have fun, and give you a bunch of information to make sure you finish this year off successfully. So, once again, I will be your host, Mr. Rico, and I hope you enjoy this watch party. It should be fun, and I will do my best to make sure we get you all out as soon as possible. Plus, there won't be no outfit changes, but it will be enjoyable, hopefully. With that being said, to make sure that we enjoy this process, we gotta stay engaged. One of the things we love about Student U is how we build community. So to keep this community going, to keep the engagement, because we only get to see each other virtually majority of the time, we have to hear from you. So if you have a question, you see something you enjoy, you see something that you're very interested in about an opportunity or something, and you wanna know more, make sure you drop it in the comments. The whole Student U team is here, and we're here to help and answer those questions, especially me. So make sure you drop those in the comments and that you engage with the watch party so that we all can learn and we all can grow and succeed this year. Now that we know that, let's do a little practice. So I'm gonna give you about 15 seconds to drop a comment and or emoji into the comment section. All right, y'all ready? All right, go. So thank you for everyone that did comment or drop an emoji into the comment session. Who knows what you'll get at the end, so stay tuned. Throughout this, we still need you to continue doing that. Once again, if you have any questions, you have something you want to say, you see something you enjoy, please place it into the comment session. So now that y'all are energized, I guess I need a little bit of energy too. So I brought coffee. Hold on. All right, cool. Now that I'm energized, we are good to go. All right, so for today, we have a full agenda, so please pay attention. So on our agenda, the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna review the spring calendar. After we review the spring calendar, we're gonna do a recap of the support team and all the things they can offer you to finish off the semester strong. They have a lot of resources. They have a lot of things that are going on throughout their spring semester. So you have to stay in tune to make sure you are succeeding as much as possible and utilizing these resources. We're also going to introduce some new faces that have joined the team. And we're going to talk about participation status. We're going to talk about Ascend. We're going to talk about the internship program, dope opportunities that we do have for this year as well, and much more. So if you're ready, I'm ready. Cool. All right, let's get it kicking. Oh, threw it too far. Here we go.
Thanks, Mr. Rico, for getting me center. Welcome to our February U Prep Day, everyone. I'm so glad that you're here, and I hope that you get a lot out of today's sessions. I want to take a minute to highlight some of the programs that we're offering this spring semester. For the month of February, we have many things happening, but three that I want to highlight. ACT prep is still happening for our current juniors. If you have questions about that, please reach out to Ms. Bianca, but the remaining dates in February are listed here on the screen. We also are opening the internship application this month. The date is here on the screen, and if you have any questions, reach out to Mr. Rico about the process. Also, the last week of February will be our virtual college tour week. Students are expected to participate, and Ms. Bianca can answer any questions that you have. Throughout the entire semester, free choice workshops are still going on. You can see the dates here on the screen. And we have three big events towards the end of the semester. April 24th will be our April U Prep Day. May 15th is the tentative date for our Family Day and Summer Academy orientation. And June 5th is the tentative date for Decision Day. At Student U, we are, of course, very carefully monitoring the COVID-19 pandemic, so if any of these dates need to be adjusted, we'll make sure to let you know ahead of time. Lastly, we did send out a letter to you recently that contained five things. A participation status letter to let you know where you and your student currently are in the program, along with a participation requirements handout so that you can be refreshed about what is required for 9th, 10th, 11th, and 12th graders in the high school program. You also should have received a spring program calendar along with a letter that lays out the events that are happening the spring semester. And lastly, you should have received, if you're in 9th grade, a summer academy letter. We are planning to hold an in-person summer academy this year, but we are asking families to opt in and sign up for summer academy so we can have accurate numbers. The deadline to sign up is March 5th. If you have any questions at all about how to sign up or questions about summer academy, please feel free to reach out to me anytime. Those are all the announcements I have for today. Thank you again for joining us for UPrep Day, and it's back to you, Mr. Rico.
Hey, thank you for that, Miss Elena. And now that we have our dope information about the rest of the spring calendar, it's time to hear from our support team. And I think the first person is Miss Bianca. So, yeah.
Thanks, Rico. Hey, everyone. It's Miss Bianca, the college advisor here at Student U. Just wanted to remind you of some things that I can help you all out with, which can include test prep materials, completing college applications, talking about financial aid and FAFSA. Seniors will be having some conversations soon here in March and April as you're receiving your financial aid award letters to just kind of talk about what is the decision that you're gonna make about where you're gonna go spend your time here in the next few years. I'm so proud of you all. I'm so proud of all the acceptances that you've got. So many of you all have shared with me, and so many more of you have to share with me about your plans post-graduation. So if you haven't already, please go ahead and make an appointment at the link below. Juniors, I'm super excited. Some of you I have already met through the ACT prep classes. The rest of you all, I will be meeting here soon in the next couple of months. The first step in getting ready for your senior year will be taking the ACT. The ACT will be offered on February 23rd through your school. So if you have questions, reach out to your school counselor to make sure that you're registered and you can take that test. And we still have ACT prep classes that you can sign up for. Those are on February 16th and 18th from 5:30 to 7:30 via Zoom. And if you would like to sign up, just use the link above. Lastly, so many of my seniors have been asking me about scholarship opportunities. Just wanted to remind you that all of the scholarships that I know about or have been sent to me are posted on the college prep page of Student U's website. So you can go there. There's also some databases that are there where you can search and find scholarships that you are eligible for. Again, the link is below, so make sure that you use that to help you find some more money to go off to school. All right, guys, I'll see you later.
Thanks, Bianca. Hey, everybody, this is Miss Alex. I wanted to give you a quick reminder of my job and how I can be supportive to you and how you can access me during this last semester of school. So I am the Director of Learning and Academic Support at Student U, which means I'm here to support you with anything and everything to help you feel more confident in school, in your classes, understanding what you're learning, staying organized, all that good stuff. A few specific things I can help out with. One, if you have an IEP or a 504 or receive any kind of extra academic support, I can be here to help you think through some of those things, to go to meetings, to advocate for new things that may be helpful. You can use me for that. Two, if you are feeling stuck in a specific class, like math just feels really overwhelming, or science is really hard, or reading just still feels a little confusing and you don't know what to do, I can step in and help brainstorm some additional resources or practice or things you could be doing to build those skills. Three, if you're feeling really overwhelmed by managing everything, and by that I mean staying organized, getting your assignments in, thinking about your time and using your time well, all things that have been particularly challenging during virtual learning, I am here to be a sounding board and a brainstorm partner to figure out what might be helpful kind of in that ball court too. So you should think about me to help with IEPs and 504s, helping you better understand what you're learning in school, and also stepping in to help you brainstorm how to stay better organized and stay on top of your work, especially with virtual school. So how can you access me? You can send in a referral and I'll touch base with you. My referral link can be found on the website, and I think you can also see it right here. You can just send in what you're struggling with and I'll reach out to you and we can make a game plan. One really important thing to know is that I am having a baby, and so I am gonna be out probably starting in April. So starting in April, I'll be out for the rest of the school year, but that doesn't mean that you can't still access all those supports. So even after April, send in that referral form. We'll have a team of people checking it and we'll be following up so that we can help you do the best you can this year, even when things are weird. Go.
Hola familias de Student U. Hey Student U families. Voy a decir mi parte en español primero y luego en inglés. I'm going to say my part first in Spanish, then in English. Mi nombre es Andrea, yo soy defensora de familias bilingües y mi papel con Student U es apoyar a las familias que hablan español y asistir con la comunicación entre nuestras familias y el personal de Student U. Algo importante para tener en mente es que yo trabajo con todo el personal de Student U, sean a tiempo parcial o a tiempo completo. Entonces, si usted quiere comunicarse con un mentor académico, un coordinador, consejero, sea quien sea quien trabaja en Student U, puede ponerse en contacto conmigo. Yo puedo asistir con esa comunicación entre ustedes. Igual, si tiene alguna pregunta sobre Student U, sea sobre requisitos de participación, tutorías, talleres, juntas, aplicaciones de Student U, cualquier pregunta que tenga sobre nosotros, igual puede comunicarse conmigo. Yo le puedo conseguir la información que está buscando. La mejor manera de ponerse en contacto conmigo es aquí, a este número. Puede mandarme un mensaje de texto o llamarme. También rápidamente quiero platicar un poco sobre nuestras promotoras de salud. Tenemos a dos promotoras trabajando con nosotros este semestre. Ellas son Carmen y Cynthia. Las dos tienen estudiantes igual que asisten a Student U, so son mamás con estudiantes en Student U y son promotoras de salud con nosotros. Ellas son un excelente recurso para cualquier pregunta que tenga relacionada con COVID-19. Por ejemplo, dónde hacerse la prueba, recursos comunitarios, información sobre las vacunas contra COVID. Puede comunicarse con ellas con cualquier pregunta que tenga sobre ese tema. Aquí tengo sus nombres y números de teléfono. My name is Andrea. I'm the Bilingual Families Advocate, and my role is to assist in the communication between our staff and our Spanish-speaking families. Really quickly, I wanted to mention our community health workers. We have Carmen and Cynthia working with us this semester. They're also our Student U parents. They're a great resource for any COVID-related need or questions. For example, where to get a COVID test, community resources, and vaccine information. So reach out to them with any of those kinds of questions. Here are their names and phone numbers. Thank you. Gracias.
Ooh, wrong person.
Thanks, Miss Andrea. So my name's Miss Ashley Peters. For those of you who don't know me, I'm just getting back from maternity leave, excited to reconnect with you guys. I'm the Director of Student and Family Support Services. And I'll give you just a brief rundown of some of the things that I do. So one is that I am a licensed counselor, a licensed therapist. And so I provide free and confidential counseling for students or parents. And so the student self-referral form is here. The parent or advocate self-referral form is here. That can be in English or Spanish. And that can be either one time, multiple times. It can be a WG Pearson with masks on outside if that's your preference, or virtual. So the second thing that I do is think about the health and wellness of our community. So things like, I don't know if you guys remember getting free eyeglasses in the past, or like we're gonna have a partnership with UNC Dental School for custom made mouth guards soon. And doing student groups, and a lot of you guys participated in the Planned Parenthood group last year. So that is another bucket. And then the third is thinking about community resources. So on our website is a list of really good community resources here that's updated pretty regularly.
I manage our student support fund. So for families who are having some financial stress, that could be an option, as well as helping to find the best community resource. That is, application is here. I'll just also say for counseling or for community resources, if we're not able to provide that service, that support, we're happy to connect you with the people in the community who do good work around that. And thanks so much. Yeah, call, text, email me, let me know. We'll be in touch and see how we can maybe be helpful. Hope you guys are doing good. And I think I'm supposed to mic drop. Bye.
Thanks, Ashley. My name is Kyle, and I'm the social work intern at Student U. My primary responsibilities are connecting students and families with mental health and wellness resources in the community and providing those services with my partner, Ashley, at Student U. I'm also working on developing and implementing a wellness curriculum, and you can learn more about the programming that we're offering by clicking the link below. Bye for now.
Oh, nice throw, Kyle, but I definitely just remember COVID, so hold on real quick. Always stay sandy up. But anyways, we're going to move on, and now we're going to introduce another new member to our team, Miss Hannah.
Thank you for the intro. I appreciate it. Hi, everybody. My name is Hannah Goforth, and I'll be working as the program team intern this semester with Student U. I am a senior at UNC Chapel Hill, where I study human development and family studies and political science. At Student U, I will be working on various projects with staff members, including tutor supervision and tracking student rewards. I am very excited for this semester and look forward to seeing everyone. All right, take it away, Ms. Michelle.
Thank you, Hannah, and welcome to Student U. All right, now we're going to move on to our participation requirements. Watch this. Okay, so you should be looking at a screen now with the participation requirements for the high school program. Everything in yellow from 9th through 12th grade are required activities for our students here at Student U. Virtual college tours and the main college tour week is happening in February. Mandatory online tutoring with Student U's high school program or with your teachers. And it is mandatory for you to meet with your advocates or academic coaches. With your advocates and academic coaches, you're meeting or talking at least once a week. And then monthly, there is a student support meeting that happens with the parent, the student, academic coaches, and advocates. There's also professional development workshops that are happening. Free choice workshops are included. U Prep Days are included in those professional development workshops. All things yellow are required to participate in Student U. As you look further in the white, these are things that we offer, programs that we offer, workshops we offer for you to join in and to learn more about with Student U. We offer course advising from 9th grade all the way through 12th grade, additional course support for 11th and 12th grade. And then we also offer financial literacy that happens in the summer and during the school year. This year, we're going to have a hybrid summer academy. And with our hybrid summer academy, you can either come to summer academy as a rising 9th or rising 10th grader, or you can opt in to receive your information by mail. We're also having our virtual ACT prep, and that's happening right now. You probably heard a little bit of that from Ms. Bianca. We are still asking for you to participate and get your volunteer hours during this time. We know it's pretty difficult to get 100 volunteer hours, especially during COVID, but we want to see that happen. Let's flip over to the next page. So on the back side of your flyer, or what you see now in front of you, is a detailed participation requirements for 9th, 10th, 11th, and 12th grade. You can see our details about Summer Academy, mandatory tutoring, your weekly advocate check-ins, U-Prep days. Our virtual cluster meetings are happening every other month, and in between that, our free choice workshops. Our community days are the U-Prep days and decision days. And then our new program with the Ascend Challenges. As you turn your page, you should be able to see the different requirements and the different ways that we are here to support you. So we're excited for you to jump in with us, excited for you to be a part of Student U and to get more information from us. All right, so now we're back with talking about Ascend. So with Ascend, this is an online goal setting program. With Ascend, we are asking for each student to create an Ascend account. All advocates will be able to support you with this. Parents, you then will be added onto Ascend, and students will work on challenges every week with their advocates, with you, on their own. They will work on different challenges to help them further reach their goals of academic success, organizational success, and success with their career goals. So we're excited for everyone to jump on board with Ascend. Make sure you check it out. Make sure you create an account. Parents, make sure you're added on as an advocate. All right, that's all for me. Bye-bye. Passing it to Mr. Rico.
So now that we've made it to the end of the watch party, the next thing to talk about is current programming and new opportunities. So let's start with current programming. Right now, we have our creative mentorship program that has already launched. So first off, let's give a round of applause to the two students that are participating within that program. These two students were in the program last year and it got cut short, so we wanted to provide the opportunity for these students to get another chance within the program. Due to it being virtual, everything is different and we had to lower the amount, but it will still be a great experience and we will learn things so that we can make the next creative mentorship program even better, especially if it's virtual. So once again, congratulations to those two students. Also, the Yes Kids program that focuses on investing and money management launched as well. So congratulations to those students that have already taken part of that program. I believe there's a few more weeks that are still there if you want to jump into that. If you do, please reach out, ask for the information, and or reach out to your advocate who also has that information. It's a lot of things that are doing, teaching kids how to invest, teaching kids how to manage their money, teaching you all how to be great financially. So it's a great opportunity. They also pair you up. You also get into groups and learn things. So if you can, take advantage of it. Next, we're gonna talk about new opportunities that Student U is presenting to you all within the high school program. First off, a entrepreneurship mentorship program. So within this program, you'll be paired with a entrepreneur mentor who's going to help you build your own business from scratch. So if you're interested in being an entrepreneur, you want to learn how they did it, what steps they went through to get to where they are, what schools they went to help them better be in the positions that they are as well, you just want somebody to be there to guide you, this is the program for you. We'll be accepting 20 students, that's right, 20 students to be in this program, and the application ends on February 24th. So if you are interested, please make sure that you jump on this opportunity. Once again, the link will be in the comments, so that way you can save it, take it over, already click on it, have that application open so you can apply. But there will be 20 spots and the program will begin at late March. So if you're interested in the entrepreneurship life, you want help seeing, or you want help building a business of your own that you already have in your mind, or you're just super interested, you know you would love to build a business, you don't know what to build, but you want to see the life of an entrepreneur, this is the program for you. The next opportunity is the Durham Mural Project. So within this opportunity, one student will be chosen to assist an artist within the Durham area on a mural that will be located on the side of a building that has just been built for new residents. So this is an opportunity for those artists that are out there that want to get that experience, want to see their art when they drive by a location. This is for you, and also it's paid. Don't forget that. We all love money. We all love things, especially money for getting paid for something we enjoy. So if you're interested in being partnered with an artist and seeing the process of creating a mural and also being able to say I assisted with that mural within this Durham area within my community, this is the opportunity for you. So make sure you get that link in the comment, you reach out to your advocate, whoever you need to get on this opportunity, so because it is a great one. Last but not least, we have the Dental Career Exploration Panel. This will take place on March 17th at 2 p.m. virtually. So you don't even have to leave, and you can learn what it takes to become a dentist, what it takes to go to dental school, what process you have to go through to get to that area. You'll be able to ask questions, hear other people's stories, see what schools they go to, and pick their brains, especially if you're interested in dentistry. And even if you're not, you want to know the medical field, you just don't know where you want to go, this is for you as well, because you'll have the opportunity to see if this is something that fits for you. So once again, that's on March 17th at 2 p.m. We'll have the link ready for you very soon, so definitely ask your advocate for it within the next coming weeks, and it should be a great opportunity for you to dive deep into some of the dental students' brain and see what it takes to get to that occupation. And now that we are done with all of the new opportunities and current programming, it's time to move on to our grade level breakout rooms, where you'll learn more information as well. So all the 9th graders will be going with Miss Michelle, all the 10th graders will be coming with me, and all the 11th and 12th graders will be going with Miss Bianca. The links will be in the comments, but before we go, for our Spanish-speaking families, we do have instructions so that you can have an interpreter during that time period as well. All right, here we go.
Buenos días. En esta reunión ofrecemos interpretación. Aquí están instrucciones de cómo escuchar interpretación en español. Si está usando un computador, en los controles de la reunión o el seminario web, haga clic en interpretación o el icono del mundo. Haga clic en el idioma que desea escuchar. Y opcional, si quiere escuchar solo el idioma interpretado, haga clic en silenciar audio original. Si está usando un teléfono, en los controles de la reunión toque el símbolo de elipsis abajo a mano derecha para ver más opciones. Luego elija la opción Language Interpretation o Interpretación y elija el idioma que desea escuchar. Opcional, toque el botón para silenciar audio original si solo quiere escuchar el idioma interpretado. Luego haga clic en finalizado.
So thank you, Miss Andrea, for that awesome voiceover. We greatly appreciate you. And now it's time to go to our breakout room. So if you have any questions, you have any concerns, once again, drop it in the chat. Let us know before you leave. The links are also in the chat and also in the comments within the video. So if you need any assistance, please let us know. But thank you again for being at this UPrep. Thank you for your participation. Thank you for being great Student U community members, Student U family, Student U students. We greatly appreciate you, and we're looking forward to the next one. Peace.